This is how I use my iPad to control Sibelius. You can use it with any program, but it works well with Sibelius. And so basically I have this template that I built. I actually took inspiration from Tim Davies, orchestrator and composer. He uses Finale, which is cool. So basically from my iPad I can pull up different windows or transpose notes, all that good stuff. The cool thing about this is that you can adapt it to your workflow, so you don't have to use any of the shortcuts that I use. I'll give you my file though so that you can use it as a starting point. It's pretty easy to set up. You need two programs, OSC or Osculator, I don't know how you pronounce it, and the OSC editor, which is the mirror to the app on the iPad. And so you build it on your computer and then you send it to your iPad. And so what you want to do is click on your sync, follow the instructions, and it's pretty simple to get it connected. In your iPad, what you want to do is click the button at the top right. Make sure that you're connected using the first menu item. You should see your computer system. And then once you get it synced up, you can send your layout to your iPad. So you go into the layouts, make sure that you have the right one selected. Cool, so everything that I see here is now on my iPad. From this point, these boxes are basically just, I use them to send OSC data. And then I use this app to convert the OSC data to whatever I want to. My computer's giving me error codes because it's processing all these commands. So when I hit escape though, you can see that it lights up right here, which is your escape button. This is enter, so when I hit the enter button, this one lights up. I also put really small directional arrows just because I thought it would be more useful than it actually is. First time you open this up, it'll give you a blank template and you just click every button. Click it in order so you don't get backwards. And then from there, you can assign a command value per button. I think you can have values, you know, trigger commands based on the program that you're in, but I haven't gotten that deep into it. I've just used it as a blanket command system. I only use it with Sibelius. To get the OSC app, you can download it from the App Store. Once you get it, you need to get the editor app, which is this app right here. It took me forever to find it, but it's on the Hexler.net website, and it's, you know, under the Touch OSC, scroll down. It's right here. It'll give you this program so that you can make your templates and all that cool stuff. So once you get it hooked up, it's pretty neat what you can do. You can take a sequence and add an octave on top of it or a fifth. It's not perfect, but makes it faster, you know. I run a lot of programs and shortcuts are a big part of workflow. For some reason, Sibelius always messed with me. There's just a lot of overlap, you know. You got Command T, which is text, Shift T, transpose, T is a time signature. I get the three backwards. So after, you know, wasting a lot of time hitting the wrong one and escaping and going back, I just built this to save me time because I like saving time. What I'll upload is .touchOSC file, and I'll give you the file that I use for Osculator, OSC Ulator. So you can start right off with being able to control your computer. I think that this program costs a decent amount. I can't remember. TouchOSC, I don't think that was bad. But anyway, if you feel like controlling your computer, iPad, it's kind of fun. It's a really cool app, you know. You can go kind of break programs by sending OSC data in behind, and then you can convert that to MIDI. I think I'm switching to Dorico pretty soon, and so I'm gonna make another template for that. But anyway, I hope that was useful. Also, I'm sorry that the score looks so terrible. I don't know what in the world I was thinking with all these slur ties that go to nothing. What is that? Oh, 2013 Mason, you and your bad formatting.